Okay, spherical mirrors. Yesterday I gave you one activity to do at home. Okay, to see your face, to see your image in the front part of the mirror, front shining part of the mirror, the curved part of the mirror, and on the from the outer surface also. Okay, so there you see that the image formed is not the same as like of the plane mirror. The properties what we have studied yesterday, we studied the four properties of the image formation by a plane mirror. The first property, the image formed is virtual and inert. Virtual images means the reflected rays do not actually meet, they appear to meet. Then such images we call it as virtual images, and virtual images are always inert. Also, the size of the image is same as that of the object. That is, the size of the object and the size of the image both are equal. The third property was the image is formed as far behind the mirror as the object is in front of it. Okay, that is, the object distance is equal to the image distance. Okay, and also this image is laterally inverted. That is, the right hand side objects are seen on the left hand side, and the left hand side objects are seen on the right hand side. Okay, now spherical mirrors are those mirrors which are a part of a sphere. Okay, it is a highly polished mirror, means it is a highly polished surface. It is a highly polished surface, but the surface is not the plane. Like yesterday we studied about the plane mirror, the mirror which is at your home, that is the plane mirror. Okay, now your spherical mirror means it is a part of a sphere. The mirror is a part of a sphere. It is a highly polished surface. It will reflect the rays. Okay, but it is spherical. Now there are two types of spherical mirrors. The first one is concave mirror, in which the inner part is the reflecting surface. The inner surface is the reflecting surface. So such a mirror we call it as a concave mirror. Okay, this is the painted surface where this dash is drawn. This is the painted surface. The inner surface is the reflecting surface. That is, the object has to be placed in front of the reflecting surface, then only the image will be formed. Okay, now behind surface is the painted surface. If you keep any object over here, it will not be reflected because the highly polished surface is the inner surface. So this type of spherical mirror we call it as a concave mirror. So it is a part of a sphere. If we complete the sphere, it is a part of a sphere. From the sphere, a part is cut and the surface is made highly polished so that it can reflect the rays. And if the inner surface is the reflecting surface, then we call it as a concave mirror. The other type is convex mirror, in which the outer surface, the bulged out surface, is the reflecting surface. That is, the object has to be placed in front of the reflecting surface, then only the image will be formed. So these are the two types of spherical mirrors. Okay, concave mirror, in which the inner surface is the reflecting surface. Convex mirror, in which the outer surface is the reflecting surface. So this spherical mirror, we call it as a concave mirror. This spherical mirror, we call it as a convex mirror. And what is a spherical mirror? A mirror which is a part of a sphere, that we call it as a spherical mirror. And it is of two types: concave mirror, inner surface reflecting; convex mirror, outer surface reflecting. Okay, and you have to place the object in front of the reflecting surface. Okay, write a question. Name the two types. Name the two types of spherical mirror. Name the two types of spherical mirrors. And draw its figure. And draw their figure. Name the two types of spherical mirrors and draw their figures. Okay, what are the two types of spherical mirrors? Concave and convex mirror. Concave mirror, inner surface reflecting. Convex mirror, outer surface reflecting. Okay, and these are the figures for the concave. This is the figure for the concave mirror, and this is for the convex mirror. Okay, you can write the answer later on. Okay, now let's proceed. Now some terms related to the spherical mirrors here we are going to study. Okay, or first write its answer so that the next question I'll dictate the answer and here we have to write out. So hurry up, write down its answer. Name the two types of spherical mirrors. Write down concave mirror, convex mirror. Concave mirror, in front of it you can write down inner surfaces reflecting. Convex mirror, write down outer surfaces reflecting. Okay, and leave some space. Later on you can draw the diagram. Leave some space. Okay, this diagram is given in the book also. From there you can draw. Or now you must be knowing how to draw the diagram. It is a part of a sphere. Okay, it is cut from a part from a sphere. That is, it is a part of a sphere, and the inner surface is reflecting, so it is a concave mirror. Outer surface reflecting, it is a convex mirror. So write the next question. Explain the following terms. Explain the following terms related to spherical mirror. Explain the following terms related to spherical mirrors. Write the first one, pole. Pole of a mirror. Okay, just write down pole. First term we have discussed is the pole. Okay, now pole is the center point of the reflecting surface of the mirror. Okay, it is the center point of the reflecting surface, whether it is a concave mirror or a convex mirror. That center point is called as the pole of a mirror. Okay, which mirror is this? I think everyone knows this is a concave mirror. This center point of the mirror, this center point of the mirror, we call it as pole, and it is represented by capital P. Okay, this is the pole of the convex mirror. This is the pole of the concave mirror. So the center point of the reflecting surface, that we call it as the pole. So write down the center point. The center point of the reflecting surface. Of the reflecting surface of a spherical mirror, of a spherical mirror, is called as pole, is called as pole, and is represented by, okay, or and is denoted by, and is represented by capital P, and is represented by capital P. Write down, it lies on the surface of the mirror. It lies on the surface of the mirror. Okay, where is it? This point lying? It is lying on the surface of the mirror. Okay, second one, center of curvature. Center of curvature. Second term, center of curvature. Now what is center of curvature? This mirror is a part of a sphere. If we complete the sphere, that sphere is having a center. That center we call it as the center of curvature. Why? Because this mirror is a part of a sphere. Okay, it is a part of a sphere. If you complete this sphere, it is having somewhere its center. Okay, this center of the sphere we call it as the center of curvature. The same way for the convex mirror, if you complete this sphere, this center of the sphere we call it as the center of curvature. Okay, so how can we define center of curvature? It is the center of the sphere of which this mirror is a part. Mirror is a part of that sphere only. So center of curvature is the center of the sphere of which this mirror is a part. So write down center of curvature. write down, it is the center of the sphere. It is the center of the sphere of which it is the center of the sphere of which the mirror is a part. PART. It is the center of the sphere of which the mirror is a part. Okay, it is represented by capital C. It is represented by capital C. So this capital C is representing the center of curvature. Written. So center of curvature is the center of the sphere of which the mirror is a part and is represented by capital C. The third term is radius of curvature. Radius of curvature is the radius of the sphere. Again, we complete the sphere. Why? Because this mirror, spherical mirror, is the part of the sphere. If we complete the sphere, the radius of that sphere, we call it as the radius of curvature. So, which distance it would be? It would be from P to C distance. Okay, P to C distance is the radius of the sphere. So, this distance we call it as the radius of curvature. So, radius of curvature is the radius of that sphere of which this spherical mirror is a part. So, write down radius of curvature. It is the radius of the sphere. It is the radius of the sphere of which the mirror is a part. It is the radius of sphere of which the mirror is a part. Write down, it is the distance from P to C. It is the distance from P to C and is represented by capital R. And is represented by capital R. Okay, one more thing. What do you note? That the center of curvature of a concave mirror is in front of the reflecting surface. Why? This is the reflecting surface. The center of curvature is in front of the reflecting surface, whereas in case of a convex mirror, the center of curvature is behind the reflecting surface. The reflecting surface is the front one and the center of curvature is behind the reflecting surface. Okay. So, as you can see in the figure also, C here is lying in front of the reflecting surface and here for a convex mirror, C is lying behind the reflecting surface. Okay, write the next one. Principal axis. Fourth one, principal axis. Principal axis. Okay, here principal spells as P-A-L. Okay, the same spelling of school principal. Principal axis. Okay, don't write it as PLA. That principal is basic principle of any device. Here it will spell it as principal PA. Principal axis. Okay, now what is principal axis? This straight line which is joining P to C. Extended straight line which is joining P to C. You extend this line. This line will be called as the principal axis and this principal axis is perpendicular to the mirror at the pole. As you can see that it is perpendicular to the mirror at the which point? At which point? Pole. So write down principal axis. Write down the straight line. The straight line joining P to C. Joining P to C and extended is called as principal axis. The straight line which is joining P to C and extended, okay, this line we have extended, is called as principal axis. Write down, principal axis is principal axis is perpendicular to the plane of the mirror Okay, now you can draw the figure for both the mirrors, concave mirror and convex mirror, in which all these points you can mention. Okay, the first mirror is inner surface reflecting. This dashed part means it is the painted one. The inner surface is reflecting. So which mirror is this? This is the concave mirror. Okay, you can draw it enough if you want to. Clear it later on, you can do that. This is convex mirror. First mark hole on it. Okay, all these points which we have discussed, we are marking on the figure. Here this point is hole. Okay, center of curvature. Somewhere here it will lie. So in case of a concave mirror, it will lie at the in front of the reflecting surface, but here it will lie behind. P to C distance. This is radius of curvature, P to C distance. This distance is radius of curvature. Extend this line, and this line we call it as the principal axis. Okay, all these terms. This is the principal axis. So you can draw both these figures. Okay, whatever terms we have studied. Okay, few more terms are there. Okay, but these terms you can show it in the figure so that it is very much clear. Hole, the center point of the reflecting surface, the midpoint of the reflecting surface. So on the surface of the mirror, the center point will be called as the hole. Whether it is a convex mirror or a concave mirror, this center point we call it as the hole. Okay, then center of curvature market. Just imagine that the sphere is complete. Wherever its center lies, that point you can mark it as center of curvature. Radius of curvature, the distance between P and P to C. Whether it is a concave mirror or it is a convex mirror. This distance we call it as radius of curvature. Extend this line. This line we call it as principal axis. So mark all the points. Okay, so that it is very clear. Okay, now the next term which we'll discuss is principal focus. Okay, everyone wrong? I give you 10 seconds more to complete this figure. Mark all the points P, C, this distance P to C, radius of curvature. This straight line, principal axis. Okay, then write on the next term, principal focus. Principal focus. Okay, which we represented by capital F. Principal focus is represented by capital F. Okay, first try to understand, then I will dictate you. Okay, for example, if it is a concave mirror. This line we call it as principal axis, now everyone knows. Okay, if the incident rays are parallel to each other, as well parallel to the principal axis. If the incident rays are parallel to each other, what are these? These are the rays, path of light, which is striking the mirror. So these rays we call it as incident rays. So if a parallel beam of incident light is falling on the mirror, is falling on which mirror is this? It's falling on the concave mirror. then what will happen? These rays will be reflected back using the laws of reflection. Yesterday we have studied whether the mirror is plane or curved. The laws of reflection are always valid. The angle of incidence will be always equal to the angle of reflection. And the incident ray, the reflected ray, and the normal all will lie on the same plane. Okay, now what happens after reflection? All these rays, they meet at a point on the principal axis. After reflection, all these rays are meeting at a point on the principal axis. This point is called as the principal focus of a concave mirror. Okay, a parallel beam of incident light after reflection by a concave mirror are meeting at a point on the principal axis. These are the reflected rays. The arrow is representing that these are the reflected rays. And these reflected rays are actually meeting at a point on the principal axis. This point we call it as the principal focus. In case of a convex mirror, a parallel beam of incident light, where will it be reflected? It will be reflected back along the same path. Okay, and after reflection, they will not be meeting at the same point. These are the actual reflected rays. These are the actual reflected rays. When they are extended backwards, they appear to meet at a point on the principal axis. This point is called as the principal focus. This point is called as the principal focus. Okay, a parallel beam of incident light, when it is striking on a concave or a convex mirror, after reflection, either the rays are actually meeting at a point in case of a concave mirror, or they are appearing to meet at a point. This point is called as the principal focus of the Okay, so write principal focus. Write down a parallel beam of incident light. A parallel beam of incident light. After reflection, either actually meets at a point on the principal axis. Okay, in the bracket, write down concave mirror. Okay, in which case they are actually meeting? Appear to meet at a point on the principal axis. Okay, write in the bracket in case of a convex mirror. This point is called as the principal focus. Okay, so what is principal focus? Principal focus is a point on the principal axis. How do we get this point? A parallel beam of incident light after reflection, either it is actually meeting at a point on the principal axis, like in the case of a concave mirror, or it is appearing to meet at a point on the principal axis. Okay, it is appearing as if all the rays are diverging from this point. So this point we call it as the principal focus. So how will we define principal focus? A parallel beam of incident light after reflection either actually meets at a point on the principal axis or appears to meet at a point on the principal axis. Okay, these are the actual reflected rays. We have extended them backwards. Okay, this point is called as the principal focus of the convex mirror. Okay, so let us revise what we have done today. Okay, we have studied about spherical mirrors. Spherical mirrors are a part of a sphere. Okay, and one surface is highly polished. That is, it is the reflecting surface. Two types of spherical mirrors here we have studied: concave and the convex mirror. Okay, if the inner surface is reflecting surface, this dash is, this is the painted surface, the inner surface reflecting surface, then we call it as the concave mirror. If the outer surface is the reflecting surface, we call it as the convex mirror. Inner surface reflecting, concave, outer surface reflecting, we call it as the concave mirror. Then some terms related to this mirror we have studied. The center part of the mirror, which is lying on the surface of the mirror, this point we call it as the pole of the mirror. Okay, so the center point on the surface of the mirror, that point we call it as the pole of the mirror. If we complete the sphere, the center point of the sphere, why? Because this mirror is a part of a sphere. Complete the sphere, the center point of the sphere, we call it as the center of curvature, which we represented by capital C. So how can we define center of curvature? It is the center of the sphere of which this mirror is a part. This is the center of the sphere of which the mirror is a part. This center point, we call it as the center of curvature. The radius of curvature, the distance between pole to center of curvature, the distance between pole to center of curvature, or you can define it as, it is the radius of the sphere of which this mirror is a part. And you see, this is the radius of a sphere of which the mirror is a part. This distance we call it as the radius of curvature. This straight line extended, if you extend this straight line, this line we call it as the principal axis. So this straight line, when it is extended, it is called as the principal axis. And principal focus, principal focus is a parallel beam of incident light. That is the incident rays of parallel, and also they are parallel to the principal axis. After reflection, in case of a concave mirror, they are actually meeting at a point. In case of a convex mirror, they are appearing to meet at a point. This point we call it as the principal focus, and we represent it by capital L. So these figures are given in the book. From there you can draw it. This is the principal focus of a concave mirror. This is the principal focus of a convex mirror. Okay, and this focus will be lying at the center point of P and C. Okay, this will go, this will discuss it tomorrow. Yes, now you can unmute yourself. And any doubt, you can ask questions.